Now let's talk about the proper method of checking on all the crossings. As you're driving towards the crossing, you physically have to move your head and look both ways. So you're holding your steering at 9 and 3 o'clock position. You physically have to move your head left, right, to check on both sides. Now a lot of people ask me, why do we need to do that? Why do we need to move our head left and right? Because we can already see there's no one there. A couple reasons behind that. Number one, if you're taking your driver's test and if you're only checking with your eyes, your examiner cannot tell if you're checking or not. But if you move your head left and right, you're making everything obvious to your examiner so he knows that you're checking on the crossings. So that definitely gonna save you some general errors in your driver's test. Number two, if you're only checking with your eyes, your vision is very limited. But if you move your head to the left and right, you can see a lot more. All right. Now, sometimes you never know if you're in a school zone, maybe there is a kid running towards a crosswalk, right? So if you're only checking with your eyes, you might not be able to see that kid. But if you move your head, you can see a lot more, and that's definitely gonna help you stay safe on the road. Number three, it's gonna help you engage with the process. A lot of time when we drive, we are thinking about something else and we are not paying attention on the road. But if you physically move your head to the left and right, that's gonna help you engage with the process. And when you engage with the process, you are actually focusing on the road instead of thinking about something else. So these are the top reasons why you physically have to move your head to the left and to the right. So make sure you're doing that, and make sure you're doing that before the crossing. If you're doing that on the crossing or after the crossing, it doesn't make any sense, then it's already too late.